I cannot bear the shame. Jane is distraught, but Helen smiles at her secretly. This gives Jane courage. Afterwards, Jane cries bitterly and Helen comforts her. Angels see our tortures. God waits with the full reward. So does Miss Temple, who comes to find them as soon as she can. She leads them both to her cozy private parlor. So after Mr. Brocklehurst leaves the institute, Jane tells Helen how insulted she feels and that she cannot bear that feeling of insult that she received at the hands of Mr. Brocklehurst. To which Helen says that she must not worry because angels are always watching over them, and in heaven God also waits, and they'll go to heaven, they will be aptly rewarded for the good behavior that they have observed, even to those people who have been unfair or mean to them. And very soon they were met by Miss Temple also, because Miss Temple was busy somewhere, but she knew that how Jane must be feeling because of the insult. So as soon as she got free, she came up to Jane and Helen and takes them to her private room. Have you cried your grief away? There Miss Temple listens while Jane tells the whole story of her short unhappy life. Then Miss Temple asks Helen very kindly about her health. With a worried look, she takes Helen's pulse. Have you coughed much today? After this, it's time for tea and toast. As a special treat, Miss Temple produces a splendid cake and cuts generous slices. You must have it. So after Miss Temple takes them to her room, the girls are comfortably seated next to a fireplace to keep them warm, and there Miss Temple asks Jane if she had cried her grief away, if she had cried enough to let go of the sadness, to let go of the bad memories that she has experienced so far. And then Jane tells her about her life, about how she became orphan, and after being orphan, how she was, you know, she went to live to her aunt's family, and how she was ill-treated by them. So Jane told her entire life story to Miss Temple. And after some time, Miss Temple looks at Helen and asks her about her health, because Helen was not keeping well for a few days, since few days. So Miss Temple asks her whether she has coughed much on that day, and then she takes Helen's pulse. That means she takes hold of her arms and she starts counting Helen's pulse, because that is a way of knowing whether the person is healthy or not. If the pulse is too slow or if the pulse is too fast, it indicates that something is wrong with the person. When we go to a doctor, many times doctor first checks our pulse. So that's his way of knowing if we are healthy, if we are perfectly fine, or if there is some problem with our health. So the same thing Miss Temple did with Helen Burns. And after she counted the pulse, she prepared tea and a toast for both the girls, and she gave a good big slices of cake to both the girls and told them that they must have it. When tea is over, all three sit happily by the fire. Helen and Miss Temple talk of wonderful faraway countries, exciting books and poems, and the marvels of nature. Listening to them inspires Jane to work hard at her studies. She wants to learn more, Miss Temple gives Jane extra time for her favorite subjects, French and drawing. She begins to feel happier. So when they finished their tea and cake, all three of them sat comfortably next to the fire, and normal conversation began between them. So Helen, most of the talks was done by Helen and Miss Temple, and they kept on talking about countries which were far away from their place. They talked about different books, different exciting books, poems which they have read so far, and the marvels of nature and how wonderful the nature was, how strange the nature was. There are so many things which we do not know about nature. So the talk between Helen and Miss Temple was about all these things, and Jane was listening to their conversation. Jane was so inspired because she came to know about a lot of things which she had which she was unaware of till now. So listening to that conversation, she got so inspired that she decided that now she will work harder, she will pay more attention to her studies, because she also became inquisitive. There was eagerness in her to learn new things, to get to know about different things. So she continued studying harder, and her favorite subjects were French and drawing, and Miss Temple knew about it, and she gave her extra time so that she can pursue her favorite subjects. She could spend more time, she could dedicate more time to her favorite subjects, which was French and drawing. So slowly with these changes, Jane started to feel happier, much happier as compared to the previous time. Springtime. At last, the weather gets warmer. Flowers grow quickly in the boggy land around the school. So do dangerous germs. Half the girls fall ill, and many of them die. Mr. Brocklehurst, the coward, stays away, but Miss Temple bravely nurses her pupils. But even Miss Temple's loving care cannot save Helen. Her disease is deadly. As days goes by, Jane indulges in her studies. She spends most of her time reading. And soon the winter time is over and it is spring season. So with the coming of spring, the climate becomes warmer, because it is not that cold. The coldness goes away and the days become warmer. As a result, the snow has melted. The land, which was soft and wet, one can see flowers growing in that land around the school. But it was also a dangerous time, because changing of season was the time when the germs became very active. As a result, many of the girls started to fall sick, and some of them had such a bad condition, such a bad health condition, that they succumbed to their sickness. That means they died because of their disease. But the owner, the person who should have been there for these girls, because he was the owner of that institute, Mr. Brocklehurst, he was such a coward that he did not even come once to check up on girls. But Miss Temple was always there, trying her best to look after each and every sick girl, and she was trying her best, but even her dedication was not able to save Helen, because the disease Helen was suffering with was a very deadly one. Very poorly. Jane knows that Helen is very, very ill. She desperately wants to see her. Helen's nurses try to send Jane away. Are you awake? But she creeps into Miss Temple's room, where Helen is being looked after. Helen looks terribly thin and pale, but she is calm and smiling. Helen believes that she is going to God, who loves her. You came to say goodbye. Now, when Helen fell sick, Miss Temple took her in her room. So, Helen was basically treated by the nurses in Miss Temple's room. And because Jane was very concerned about her health, she used to ask the nurse about her medical condition, to which the nurses used to tell her that Helen is not well, she is not improving, her condition is not improving. So Jane requested the nurse to let her in, to allow her to meet her friend, which the nurses refused and sent Jane away. So when the nurses were not present in the room, Jane creeps into Miss Temple's room to check upon her best friend and ask her if she was awake. When she saw Helen, she realizes that Helen has become very sick. She has gone pale. Her color is dull. One can see, weakness in her eyes. There is no liveliness on her face. She had become very weak, very thin, but she was very calm and smiling because Helen believed that her time has come and that God is going to call her to heaven. She believed that it was her time to go to her God, because she believed that God loves her a lot, and that is why God is calling her to heaven. Good night. Good night. Jane is heartbroken. She does not want to lose her good, kind friend. She climbs onto Helen's bed and wraps her arms around her. That is how Miss Temple finds them. Both are very peaceful. Jane is asleep, but Helen has died. So when Jane creeps into Miss Temple's room, Helen asks her whether she has come to say her goodbye. So they talk for a while, and then both of them wish each other good night. Now Jane knew that Helen's time has come, that it was Helen's end was near. So she was very heartbroken, she was very sad, but because she did not want to lose a friend who was very good. Helen was a very good friend of hers. So in the last moments of Helen, she did not want to be kept away from her. So Jane climbs onto Helen's bed and hugs her, wrapped her arms around her, means she hugged Helen, and both of them fall asleep. And when the next morning Miss Temple enters her room, she finds both of them peacefully. Both of them were lying very peacefully. The only difference was that Jane was still alive. She was asleep, whereas Helen had passed away.